sometimes working personal, interpersonal, and transpersonal. It helps people integrate both the experiential part of what we're doing, which is body-based, nervous system-based, and the creative right brain and the didactic left brain. Get your face in real close to your camera and just notice what you see when you're very close to the camera. And that's the basic idea, one of the basic ideas of the observing ego, which is it allows us to see the big picture. Oh, this is wonderful. And they were sending me pictures of using spectrograms and locograms. We're building a container that allows people to work safely with their trauma. And we're building it in a stepwise fashion.
It felt very safe to put it inside this frame.
How many times I have to tell you, I'm in charge of my own homework. I don't need you to remind me.
Well, the teacher, all right? Your teacher called and told that, like, right now I have to check your homework because I know that you didn't do it.
No, this is my life. Back off.
There was loud voices back and forth. No real communication.
And by adding the humming to it, both breathing and humming are ways to activate the ventral vagus nerve, which is the part of the nervous system that supports social engagement. All right.
I want more of it.
And that's something that is wonderful about step-in circles, because people can say that. They can say, you know, that's something I'd like more of. Step in if you've ever felt unsafe in your body. And then ask people to explain what that was.